Apple's new Mac Mini has been released and includes not only the latest M4 and M4 Pro chips, but also, most surprisingly, it's had its first design update in 14 years. In this video, I'll be going over everything you need to know about this exciting new bit of kit, including how it compares to the previous M1 and M2 models, whether it's worth the upgrade, and what the new addition of Apple Intelligence into their products actually means. Firstly, if you're new to Mac Minis and wondering what they're all about, all you need to know is they're a mini desktop computer and have proven themselves to be very powerful and capable over the years. They also last a very long time, and I used my first one for nearly 10 years. They're also the cheapest way to get into Apple's macOS ecosystem, but don't come with a screen, keyboard or mouse, so you can add a fancy Apple screen or a cheaper third-party one. Check out the affiliate links in the description below to get one for yourself, but otherwise, let's get started. Undoubtedly, the most striking difference for this Mac Mini is its size. It sits slightly taller than the previous design, but has a much smaller footprint, measuring just 12x7x12.7cm, which is around half the old models. It's quite unbelievable just how much smaller the Mac Mini is, with Apple claiming it's 20 times smaller than conventional computers. Another fundamental change is the layout in ports. Unlike the prior design we all know so well, this new model houses two USB-C ports on the front, both supporting USB 3.0, as well as a headphone jack, which is in a very practical position. On the back, there's a power input with a cable supplied in the box. Next to it sits the Ethernet port, then a standard HDMI port to connect a display, and three Thunderbolt 4 ports. So despite the loss of USB-A ports on this new model, there are five ports that will accept either USB-C or Thunderbolt. However, if you buy a version with the M4 Pro chip, then you'll get upgraded to three Thunderbolt 5 ports on the back, which is a new faster standard that has only recently been announced. The one thing which perhaps isn't so practical, however, is the new position of its power button. Turn the Mini over, and next to the circular air vent is the button in question, so you'll now have to lift it up and reach under every time you want to power it on. I'm not sure why Apple would choose to do this. Perhaps they don't think people turn their devices off regularly and just put them to sleep. But it certainly feels reminiscent of the Magic Mouse, which seems destined to always have an inconvenient underside charging port. I've seen a few ingenious 3D printed accessories to solve this issue, but if, like me, you mount your Mini on the back of your screen or under your desk to save space, then it probably won't be too much of an issue. As it's still early days for M4 Mac Mini mounts, I grabbed this adjustable one off Amazon, and I'll leave a link to it in the description below if you're interested. Nevertheless, whilst the power button is awkward, it isn't a deal breaker, and sometimes you just have to accept these things when the rest of the product is so good. As usual, Apple has provided the option of building your Mac Mini M4 with a number of different configurations, starting with the cheapest base model, which I have here, though all the models have the same design and number of ports, so you can't actually tell them apart. This base model has got the M4 chip with 16GB of unified memory, up from a minimum of 8GB on previous models, and a 256GB SSD for storage. Unified memory was introduced by Apple in 2020 when they moved away from Intel chips. It means that the CPU and GPU use the same amount of memory instead of the GPU having its own separate memory, making the system much more efficient. And if you're wondering why I'm not mentioning an M3 chip in this video, it's because Apple never released an M3 chip in the Mac Minis. All the Mac Mini M4 chip configurations feature a 10-core CPU, a 10-core GPU, a 16-core neural engine, and gigabit Ethernet. You can upgrade the storage from the base 256GB SSD all the way up to 2TB, the unified memory from 16 up to 32GB, and the Ethernet can be up to 10Gb. Apple has also introduced an M4 Pro chip, which offers a significant improvement on the M4. There are two setup options for the Pro chip. The first has a 12-core CPU, 16-core GPU, and 16-core neural engine. And the second has a 14-core CPU, 20-core GPU, and a 16-core neural engine. Both of these are configurable with 24, 48, or 64GB of unified memory, and from 512GB up to a massive 8TB in SSD storage, whilst the Gigabit Ethernet can also become 10Gb if you wish. This beefier setup translates to superior performance for high-power applications such as gaming, 3D rendering, and video editing. And in case you're interested, because I was, Adding up all the upgrades to the M4 Pro chip will come to an eye-watering £4,699 or dollars. So how does the M4 compare with Apple's previous Mac minis powered by the M1 and M2 chips? For reference, the M1 chip had an 8-core CPU and 8-core GPU, while the M2 chip was an improvement with an 8-core CPU and a 10-core GPU. However, the M4 takes this further, providing improved CPU speeds and GPU capabilities, making it more powerful than the M2, which you'd hope as it is an upgrade. In terms of numbers, Apple says the M4's CPU is about 1.8 times faster and the GPU is 2.2 times faster than the M1. Compared to the M2, the memory bandwidth in the M4 has been boosted by 20%, up to 120 gigabytes per second, which means heavy data applications will run more smoothly. This upgrade is particularly noticeable in tasks like video editing, which I'm already seeing the benefit of putting this video together. However, the M4 chip's real strength is its upgraded neural engine, with Apple saying that the neural engine in the M4 Pro is 3 times faster than the one in the M1. This means tasks involving machine learning or AI-based processes will be much quicker and more efficient. The M4's neural engine can apparently handle 38 trillion operations per second, up from the M1's 11 trillion and the M2's 15.8 trillion. And just for an external comparison, tests are showing the M4 chip to be outperforming Intel's 14th generation i9 chip, which is a really impressive benchmark. Another big highlight of the M4 Mac Mini lineup is display support. Impressively, the M4 base model can handle up to 3 displays, 2 6K and 1 5K via Thunderbolt, whilst the M4 Pro can handle 3 6K displays, ideal for creative professionals who work with high-res visual content. As mentioned earlier, you're only getting the Mac Mini and not a screen when you buy it, so you'll need to splash out more cash on a screen, but it gives you the flexibility to choose one which suits your needs and budget. Now let's tackle the big question. If you already have an M1 or M2 Mac Mini, is it worth upgrading to the M4? If you're an M1 user like me, this upgrade is very appealing, given the substantial gains in CPU and GPU power. The M4's 1.8 times CPU performance and 2.2 times GPU performance increases, plus the larger memory capacity starting at 16GB, make this a solid choice for anyone needing a bit more speed and multitasking capability, and I certainly noticed a difference from the moment I turned it on. For those with an M2 Mac Mini, the decision may be a little tougher. Whilst the M4 does offer more memory bandwidth and improve neural engine performance, the jump from an M2 Pro chip to the M4 chip probably wouldn't be worth it in my opinion. Upgrading from the M2 Pro to the M4 Pro would be a lot more noticeable, especially thanks to the enhanced neural engine, which looks to improve AI and machine learning tasks. The Mac Mini has always been the cheapest way to get onto Apple's ecosystem, and there was a worry when specs for the M4 model began to leak that the improvements in performance would mean it lost its lower price tag. Thankfully, Apple has kept the M4 Mac Mini at a really good price point. The M4 base model starts at £599 or $699, which remains very competitive for the amount of performance and functionality it offers. If you add all the upgrades, however, your 32GB, 2TB, 10Gigabit M4 Mac Mini will cost you £1,899 or dollars. Apple's M4 Pro configuration starts at £1,399 and tops out at £4,699 or dollars. At those price points, you may be starting to look towards the Mac Studio, which contains the M2 Max and M2 Ultra chips. For many users, including myself, but the base model will more than see needs met and exceeded for both home and office use, with a great balance of price to performance. An additional feature announced just prior to the M4 chips is Apple Intelligence, Apple's suite of generative AI capabilities, which is being integrated across Apple's ecosystem, including iPhone, iPad, iMacs, and Mac Minis. It's available from December 2024 through their latest operating system and runs on Apple Silicon, meaning that if you upgrade your M1 or M2 Mac Mini to macOS Sequoia, released in September 2024, then you can also access Apple Intelligence. The capabilities include enhanced Siri integration, offering more natural and flexible interactions, integration with ChatGPT, privacy and on-device processing, meaning it isn't necessary to send your personal data to the cloud. Writing and communication tools, including rewriting, proofreading and summarizing text, and image and video creation. It'll be really exciting to see how Apple Intelligence improves workflow, creativity, and day-to-day use on the Mac Minis, and if you're interested in trying it before December, then it's available in beta at the time of writing. Another interesting announcement from Apple regarding the new Mac Mini lineup is that it's the first carbon-neutral Mac. According to Apple, it's designed with more than 50% recycled materials, made with electricity sourced from 100% renewables, and 50% of the Mac Minis have even been shipped using low-carbon methods. Whilst it's undoubtedly a good thing and nice to know this, I think it's probably a drop in the ocean compared to Apple's impact on the planet over the years. To wrap things up, the Mac Mini M4 is a powerhouse in a small package, with plenty of memory and display support options, impressive CPU and GPU boosts on previous models, and the power to handle almost any task you throw at it. The base model alone will likely be more than enough for general users, and it's great to see it offers a noticeable improvement over the M1 and M2 models, especially in memory capacity and neural engine speeds. If you need even more, the M4 Pro offers incredible expandability with advanced graphics options and support for more displays and memory. It's a powerful setup that makes the Mac Mini lineup even more competitive in today's market. Let me know in the comments what you think of the new Mac Mini M4. Would you upgrade? Don't forget to check out the links in the description if you'd like to get one for yourself. It helps me continue to make these videos at no extra cost to you. And if you enjoyed the video and think I've earned it, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tech breakdowns and reviews. Catch you next time, and thanks for watching.